my God.
To the Greg log. It's a bong of brilliance in a head shop of hell. I don't think I can follow them.
Greg log.
This story's kind of stupid compared to...
Yeah, let's keep talking about prison.
All right.
Probably go out now.
So a wrestling star known as R-Truth lit up a cigarette on Raw Tuesday night, and now one rage-infested anti-smoking activist is demanding that he apologize. Why? Because he lit up in front of a row of precious little children who were there to watch two grown men in tiny underwear beat the crap out of each other, as opposed to smoke, because smoking is evil, as opposed to steroids, violence, and satin underpants. Here's tape. This is probably a stunt. R-Truth is supposed to be a bad guy, and bad guys smoke. See my weird Uncle Seth? Well, he does more than smoke, actually. But we won't get into that here because it's troubling and makes me sad. But even the involvement of anti-smoking activist Patrick Reynolds manufactures outrage and is part of this drama, whining to TMZ, quote, "For him to smoke in front of children is irresponsible. At best, it's thoughtless. And at worst, if he calculated appealing to kids by posing as a bad boy outlaw," which I do, "it's evil." Only on Halloween. Meanwhile, the WWE defends the incident, saying negative depictions of tobacco use on TV are not unusual and can be seen on other programs. True. But my response might have been, children come to watch glorified abuse and mayhem, and you're offended by the smoking? Blow it out your butt, you big fusspot. In this age of misguided priorities tethered to infantile outrage, smoking is the easiest thing to get angry about. While mobs beat the crap out of innocent people on subways and buses, at least here with smoking, you can express feeble rage without fear of retribution. It's perfect for pro wrestling, safe and fake. And if you disagree with me, you are a racist homophobe. Terry, is smoking the worst thing that was going on in that arena?
First of all, A, fusspot is the best word ever.
It truly is.
And I've spent most of my adult life trying to stay in shape and all that kind of stuff. If I had known that smoking cigarettes would cut me up like that, dude, I'd have been smoking since I was on the football team in high school. Where have I been?
Yeah, it's
That's
true.
That's awesome.
You know, it's interesting.
That guy's jacked.
It's interesting you mention that because Brooke was selling some very kind fuss pot before
the
show.
I'm going to get $20 a bag. After the show, okay? Disbarred.
But you're going to be re-awesomed.
Back to the story, Andrew. story. Is smoking probably the worst thing you can do right now on the planet?
Did you see R-Truth's pecs?
Yes.
Okay, I did too. Okay. Is he supposed to be like a role model? I didn't get that vibe from him when, when he got out of the ring.
No, it's true. It's like it's like going to the movies and seeing a villain in the movies and going, that villain, like Predator smoking.
Yeah, it doesn't make any sense. Like, the kids are smart enough to recognize that the villain do bad thing. If they kill a person in a movie, kids aren't saying, let's go out there and murder people, going, that's the bad guy. The bad guy just taught people smoking is bad.
See, my parents were different. They would take me to the movies and they would tell me this was all real. And that was it. Yeah, that was it. I don't know why they did it, really. They also did a lot of other things.
It's also changed a lot. When I was growing up as a little kid, my mom and dad had these big parties at our house. Everybody smoked.
Same here.
Everybody drank. In the morning, I'd come up and taste the lock. Mom, I'm sorry. I didn't do this already. I'm not telling her anything.
Spit out cigarette butts in the
I even went to, admitted to the hospital. I was really sick, and I tried a medicine, and I spit it out. I'm like a five-year-old kid, and I go, this tastes like Drambuie. And the doctor's like, what? How do you know how to say that? My mom was like, oh, my God. She was mortified.
Hey, that's great, kid. Call child services.
Okay, that was the way it was.
I got less than 60 seconds. Brooke, what are your thoughts on this? You're for kids' rights and all that
crap. Yeah, but I mean, this guy is so ugly, okay? I mean, he's ugly. So this is obviously a negative depiction of smoking. I mean, what kind of kid's going to want to emulate that? But if you watch the full video, you have that person in the front row screaming, will somebody please think of the children, literally like that. It's ridiculous.
Yeah, and that's coming from a children's rights advocate. Yeah. That's what I love about
Well, to be honest, a stone human rights.
Can we gotta go. Stop it?
Coming up, is it hard to be hot when the world is so ugly? Brooke Goldstein discusses her new book, It's Hard to Be Hot When the Ugly World is So Ugly. Whatever. Hey, look, it's sexy girls dancing.
That's why, yeah.
Sadly, they all got Legionnaire's disease. Just kidding. Anyway, thanks, sexy girls dancing. They're delightful. Could being hot hurt your lot? And do interviewers pick only the ugly chicks? Well, a study has found that attractive women who attach a photo to their resumes are less likely to get an interview than homely job hunters or those who don't include a pic. I like how they're showing somebody wearing glasses right there. What does that mean? The research published in the Royal Economic Society, sounds like a gang, blames jealous women who work in personnel departments. But no surprise, the reverse is true for men. Attractive dudes who attach a pic to the resume are more likely to get an interview. They may be onto something there. I handpick everyone who works for Red Eye. Can we see tape from our staff meeting today?
I like how they don't really know what to do.
I like how they went back to you as opposed to me.
I like it.
All right.
Yeah, right to them.
Hey, Brooke, why are women so cruel to each other? Why? Why are you so cruel to other women?
Well, I think this study is bogus. Really? I don't buy it. I don't think the reason is because of jealousy. But the one part, you know, they did get right, you know, handsome man, picture, CV, hired. That is my policy at the Lawfare Project. That's what we do. But I read the full article, and the study was actually conducted in the West Bank.
Mm.
How ironic is that? I mean, what's a hot girl in the West Bank? You know, like the burqa is off a little
bit. That's a good point.
I find that kind of tantalizing. Hey, Andrew, do we need a civil rights movement for beautiful people?
Yes. You know when you're on Facebook and you get friends across and they're just mediocre looking people and I say, yes, I accept the friendship.
Yeah.
But when it's like a really hot chick, I get scared and I say no, like that I'm being entrapped or something. But
it's not real.
Or that people are going to look at my new friends and look and go, he's picking them because they're attractive.
I thought about that.
I'm worried about that.
That's why I pick nothing but really large, hairy men. I guess you would call them bears. Yeah. I don't know.
Actually, I had that similar experience when I first started Twitter. Like, the only ones I would pick would be hot girls, but then I realized I got the worst part of the hot girls, just hearing their thoughts. That's it. That is like, if you had to pick out of a whole handbag of the stuff you get from a hot girl, that would be the one you'd keep.
Yeah.
So that's why we're not friends on Twitter, then.
I didn't know you were on Twitter.
You don't
think
I'm attractive?
I don't think you're attractive. I have eyes. But I like
and
your
you
thoughts.
Do drugs all the time, too.
I like your thoughts, and I will befriend you on Twitter for your mind. And thank God God gave you that, because that's all you got. What? If we cannot speak the truth on Red Eye, where can we?
Where can we?
You're hideous, but you're very smart. Very smart.
Oh, jeez. Hey, Terry, isn't this all bogus? Ugly people are discriminated more than anybody on the planet. If anything, people should be organizing for the plain and the homely.
I feel like I'm on a spaceship, dude. Like, I feel like I'm whirling around so fast, I can't even, do I grab him? I don't know. Brooke's really pretty, but you don't think she is?
Planet Brooke's not hot.
Like, what's up, what's down? The laws of physics, by the way, if this is true, that's the only time a hot chick doesn't make out.
Yeah, that's true.
Come on.
No, but I want to tell you this, and I'm not including Fox News in this, because I find that the Fox News HR department, superlative, they do great work.
Yes.
Whenever I need anything. But do you remember Dennis Publishing at Maxim and stuff? The HR girls were extremely mean to other women, I remember.
Oh, absolutely.
Really? Give them jobs.
Yeah, totally.
Maybe I just made that up.
Well, they were always very mean to other women and me.
Yeah.
And I thought that was weird.
Well, that's because they often mistook you for
I would pound
the
on their
pro,
office female. Door and just be like, I'm a dude. Nothing.
All right. If you have a comment on the show, email us. It's redeye@foxnews.com. To leave a voicemail, my direct line, call 212-462-5050. Still to come, the halftime report from Mike Baker, a suave but evil man.
Tonight's halftime report is sponsored by meerkats. Those small members of the mongoose family found mostly in Africa and immune to certain types of venom, whose average lifespan is 12 to 14 years. Thanks, meerkats.